Tourism have come along, and you know, thank you to all of you on the panel who have opened up these businesses. It really has given another opportunity for people to come and see and visit and stay and come back.
Great festivals, we own this great beer. So when we hear such breweries that are struggling a little bit, we don't like to hear that, as we don't really have competitors in New Jersey in breweries. It's pretty funny. It's a very small niche type environment. There may be some people you disagree with and don't get along with, but at the end of the day, we don't want to see any brewery go out of business.
Share, if you will, a success story as it relates to marketing, educating, or informing various publics about your roles in beverage tourism. So in other words, how has your business or organization successfully connected with the general public?
We're fortunate. We throw festivals and events that people want to go to. Based off of lifestyle, it's based off of food, it's based off of wine, it's really based off of beer. So our marketing messages and our wins have always been with the climate of craft beer and fun. A lot of these breweries, like you guys, really met Ryan. He's a fun guy. Well, that's what a lot of these breweries portray, and that allowed us to do the same thing through our marketing, through kitschy videos, through social campaigns, and advertising, and made it fun to show you, hey, Atlantic City, New Jersey is fun, and here are our beverage partners, and here's some of the stuff we want to pour in your face. We want you to chow down, come to Atlantic City, and meet these people.
Career path that had nothing to do with marketing. Today, I spend a lot of my time thinking about marketing and strategy and how we're talking to our customers and those folks who are thinking about our beer or looking at our beer. And the majority of the marketing that we do is really through stories. Nobody wants to listen to like statistics on like, well, our beer is technically the most accurate to style. Fuck that. we wanna like have really fun, engaging stories.
Does our organization agree with this statement?
We were putting our packaging together. We weren't even gonna go to market, and knowing that the industry as a whole does about 40% of their sales on the retail side, at least between 2 weeks leading up to Thanksgiving and Christmas Eve, not even New Year's Eve, Christmas Eve. The thing we're going to miss that was troubling to say the least, but we quickly went to market on December 10th, and a last minute decision was to put ACNJ on the security neck wrap that goes around the cork. And going to stores and doing tastings, and the number of people that came up to us and just were so like kind of happy and proud and excited about the fact that this was coming from Atlantic City, New Jersey, from the surrounding markets. It was absolutely like overwhelming.
Don't visit Napa Valley. It's about Napa Valley wines, right? Or Sonoma Valley. There's no reason why it can't be the Outer Coastal Plain, which is our federally recognized viticultural area. That's right in this area. And it's in New Jersey. Right? So that's one of the big draws to our winery, is that we are local, that we're right here.
I guess like craft beers and a lot of craft beverages are targeted towards like the 30-year-old, 25 and above age group. But have you guys ever thought about like targeting like the legal drinking age college student? Seeing them go out of college talking about this type of industry?
You're in a unique age group to where, your spirits, your beers, your wines, your liquors are better than your parents. There's more care and thought that goes into, making your food and making your drink now than there was when all of us were younger, and your parents were younger. So you're in a unique time where, beer, wine should be an opportunity for discovery, not an opportunity to go get shit-faced.